Rather feel when I leave this shell eventually. Ties to the mother earth ground me mentally. Real vibes keep me alive spiritually. Imagination brings bliss at no cost. When I blink, blink, I receive at no loss. Victory comes in small packages like a leaf off an olive tree. Brought back by a dove from above, then I'm gonna rhyme love. We saw that we're coming ever since the beginning of the end. Well, anyways, I'm not a perfect being. Yes, I am a man full of S.I.N. Like the devil in me, saw the God in you. You epitomize the etymology of enthusiasm. Look it up there, lies the clouds that form the rain that came from the ocean that flow from the river. I'm a believer, firm with the first words, lyrical transceiver of our ancient roots. Science plus arts multiplied by faith, then divided by the number of our ethnic race. Let me mention what I've been thinking, how to save the children when the ship is sinking. So I'm sinking, no lip syncing, slogans political. With tech missiles and guns, everything is relative when it's all in the family. Oh man, I understand the time has finally come to realize the great power of one. All formulas equalize under the sun, amen.
What's up, guys? Welcome to my channel. And I don't normally do any opinionated thoughts after an AMV, but I felt like this one was very important and necessary. So after watching for the first time the full movie called Akira, there's a lot of, I can see propaganda that's kind of implanted in the movie to influence the youth. And I know this movie came out in what, 1980s or something, and its art style and animations is very high quality. Even today, a lot of modern day Japanese anime, they're trying to catch up or at least trying to replicate it, but they can't because the detail is so deep in the actual anime. And actually when it came out, I can read online, no one really understood it. They're starting to get a grasp of it, but back then no one understood it. All they understand was that it was about motorcycles and explosions, and like for some reason people were associating it with the atomic bomb that was dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, but it had nothing to do with about the atomic bomb. It has everything to do with the same thing I always talk about on this channel, the same lie that Satan taught in the Garden of Eden, the evolution of man. And in the story, it takes place after Tokyo has been destroyed by essentially and pretty much a nuclear bomb that was actually created by these scientists who were trying to do experiments on children and trying to tap into some kind of power that is within the human body, that they want to harness this power to become essentially evolved humans and essentially godlike. Now the name Akira, Google can try to paint it out any way they want. They want to say that it means intelligence or wisdom or light. It's very interesting that actually they say light, because light represents the devil. Lucifer, the secret societies that control our world, they all control each part of the world, and they pretty much are collaborating with one another to put the same message within all our media. And after World War II, after they did bomb, they created the whole World War II scenario. They funded both sides, and after Japan gave up, they pretty much installed their own puppets there, because ever since then, all this media that they've come out has pushed the same stuff. It all links towards the Eastern philosophies about reincarnation, dualism, the false reincarnation and duality, that your good deeds outweigh your bad, good and bad karma. And I love Japanese culture and I love the Japanese people, but essentially their culture, if they're religious, they pretty much, there's a multiple lesser gods that they can choose to pray to, and they don't believe in one true God that created everything. They pretty much pray to these lesser gods, and you can just choose whichever one you want to pray to. Essentially, their whole philosophy is about how man can ascend to a higher state of being and pretty much transcend this realm. And in the movie, they talk about how they can transcend into like a light being.
A young researcher asked me the other day if we are really on the threshold of a new form of human evolution. A humanity of pure energy and limitless power.
Ha! A typical romantic. All you scientists are. We soldiers begin by considering the risk. It's taken all of 30 long years. We've progressed quite a way since that Holocaust, and we can't risk losing it all now because of this.
But Colonel, I'm surprised you feel anything for this rotting metropolis.
The people lost their pride in our great achievement a long time ago. Now all these fools care about is indulging themselves.
Now, that word, a god, has been thrown around a lot loosely quite often. And in the show, you could say that the character became godlike. But if you think about it in reality, he wasn't a god, because a true god could create a whole world, a whole universe with just spoken words. And he could create life, intelligent life, and beauty, so many things that when we see a character who's godlike in some kind of media or movie, television show, they're just like an overpowered superhero. They can destroy stuff, but they can't really create anything. Yeah, when you Google the word, what does Akira mean? Pretty much means, they say it's a combination, the characters are a combination of the sun and moon, and that it has a meaning about like intelligence or truth, sunlight and moonlight. But you have to remember that the elites, they're actually sun and moon worshippers. So sun and moon worship, it would mean a god. And if you watched the Japanese dub of Death Note, the character, he changes his name to Kira. And in the end, he actually says Kira Dakara, which means I am a god. So Akira is just another way to say a god. What happened was that no characters in the show are inherently good. They're all like inherently bad. or evil people. The two main characters are Tetsuo and Kaneda. And actually, I think I like Tetsuo. When I didn't watch this show, I just saw pieces of the fight scenes and stuff. I liked Tetsuo because he looked cool and he was able to hold himself in a fight, and he's the older one. But he's actually kind of a loser, actually, and he's such a simp. And I liked Tetsuo because he was bullied by him, and I just felt like he was the more justified one, but he kind of let his power that he obtained from the scientific experiment that was done on him to corrupt him. And he became corrupted and so powerful. He pretty much killed Kari, the only one who loved him truly. And Kaneda, his best friend, was trying to help him by killing him right away and always talking down to him. And essentially they were in a gang, a biker gang, and I'm pretty sure they killed a few people indirectly when they had a bike accident that a bike flew through some kind of restaurant and struck a man in the head. I'm pretty sure he died from that. They were pretty much car bombing. And then there's this evil scientist that are the ones, and this colonel, right? And he's like, they're both evil because the colonel and him were trying to harness the power of to become godlike and evolve mankind, which is what the elites are doing. And they do have these huge facilities, I'm sure, like CERN is probably one of these facilities. It's either meant to open a portal or to try to figure out how to use science to evolve man, because these fools truly believe that they can transcend this realm, but it'll never work. It's just going to be destruction of mankind, as they'll probably open a portal to hell, and they probably already have. But yeah, essentially, when I was looking at the comments, a lot of people didn't really understand, but in the end, it's about how man can evolve. And they even push the whole evolution theory lie into the actual a segment of the movie. I can play it here.
He said Akira has achieved pure energy.
Pure energy?
A human being, you know, achieves a whole lot of things in a lifetime, right? Like discovering things and making things, like houses and motorbikes and bridges and towns, rockets. Where does that tremendous knowledge and energy all come from? After all, humans are descended from monkeys, right? And before that, insects, and then fish. And long before that, plankton and one-celled amoeba. When you think about it, each life form must have its own energy.
Well, that's evolution, right?
I'm talking about the life force that exists, even perhaps in water and atmosphere, perhaps even in space dust. If they evolved, they must hold some memory locked inside. If it could reach back, even before the beginning of time...
But after they're done their conversation, you have to understand that as soon as the evolution theory lie that there's no evidence for to prove that anything changed from one kind to another, they'll always say, we need more time, we need more time. But as soon as that was being taught mandatory in schools, the rate of crime, the rate of all sorts of crimes, from murder to rape to theft to unwed births to underage sex, all this stuff skyrocketed in the 1970s. So it's because if you teach that we are animals and we came from monkeys, then the youth are going to act like animals. But when everyone knows that there's a God above and he's perfect and he has rules that we have to follow, then everyone will fall in line. Well, most people will because they know that eternity and judgment is just around the corner. And also they show this committee of like secret government officials who are higher up that actually control one government, but in reality they have this committee that control all the world. They've existed for centuries. These elites have always existed thousands of years ago. There's always been a group of higher up that hides information and use their massive wealth to pit the poor to fight against one another. Essentially, it shows that ultimate power corrupts ultimately. Oh yeah, and then the scientists, they're so evil. They did all the experiments and they pretty much cut up this boy into pieces. And then the other children experiments, they actually start using their psychic power and praying to the pieces of him. He manifests and into his form, and he's like a all-powerful light being. Yeah, just all I can say is that, I mean, this movie and a lot of anime just show a lot of demonic, either demons and a lot of Akuma and stuff like that, or they just try to promote that same belief that man can transcend to a god when there really is one true god who's going to judge everyone. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. God bless you and your families.